is presented by DraftKings. And Geico brings us the tale of the tape for the WBO Welterweight World Championship. Kell Brook, we have discussed it, is the naturally bigger man. But Terrence Crawford, look at that reach, 74 inches. And look at that last line. Power, punch, connect percentage, just short of 50%. Second best among all active fighters in the sport. We are here in what has been termed the bubble, the COVID-safe zone at the MGM Grand. Unlike anything Crawford has experienced, the champ has ridden the roar of winning titles in front of 20,000 in Nebraska. He's felt the glory that comes with being crowned the king at Madison Square Garden. But now this is where he will defend his newly acquired status as pound-for-pound number one. To the ring we go in Mark Chinook.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome inside the MGM Grand here in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada, minutes away from our main event. Here to perform God Save the Queen, please welcome London theater star, recording artist, and Las Vegas entertainer, Danny Walton.
God save our gracious Queen, long live our noble Queen. God save the Queen. Send her victorious, happy and glorious, long to reign over us. God save the Queen.
Thank you, Danny. And now, to honor our veterans and this great nation, here to sing the Star Spangled Banner, America's Got Talent semifinalist, and recently featured on I Can Hear Your Voice, singer-songwriter Samantha Johnson.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
He may well be the best fighter in the world. Not merely undefeated, but long a fixture on everyone's pound for pound list. That list is changing though. A takeover is in progress, new generation ascending. And the truth is, at 33 and still looking for that signature fight, Terrence Crawford's running out of time. Pound for pound is hypothetical, of course.
Pound for pound, who's the best fighter in the sport?
Canelo Alvarez.
But the debate it engenders leads to consensus.
For the record, Terrence Crawford is my number one pound for pound.
And consensus spurs a kind of immortality. Epic careers require epic rivals. But Crawford, unlike his predecessors, has none. Blame the greedy promoters, the reluctant opponents.
Spence, whenever you're ready, I'm here.
And if you think a fighter is obliged to play provocateur, then blame Crawford too.
I'm about that action. I ain't about all that talking.
Just acknowledge his conundrum. Kell Brook was once a great fighter. Perhaps he can be that again tonight. That would be poetry. But poetry is not a pound-for-pound metric.
I'm taking them how they come, and I'm knocking them off.
In the meantime, Crawford's left to the most dangerous kind of task. An undefeated champion from whom everything's expected, fighting a guy with nothing to lose.
Kell Brook will need to create a storm tonight. All the Lights by Kanye is what he has chosen. It wasn't long ago when Brook was considered one of the most gifted fighters in the world. Big and strong as any fighter at 147 pounds. 6 years ago, he muscled his way past the then undefeated Sean Porter, took a world title. And he has told anyone who will listen this week that he knows for fact that he's in better shape now, stronger, fresher, more capable than he was then. Chinook.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome inside the MGM Grand here in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada. This is boxing. This is Top Rank, presented by Hall of Fame boxing promoter Mr. Bob Arum and brought to you by Geico. This bout is scheduled for 12 rounds for the WBO Welterweight Championship of the World. And now to the millions watching on ESPN and around the world, this is boxing. This is Top Rank, and this is the main event. Our judges at ringside, Dave Moretti, Patricia Morris-Jarman, and Benoit Roussel. And the man in charge at the sound of the bell, Mr. Tony Weeks. Introducing first out of the blue corner, he weighed in at 147 pounds, wearing white trunks with red and blue trim. He brings a record of 39 wins, only two defeats, 27 of those victories coming by way of knockout. The former welterweight world champion from Sheffield, England, the special one, Cal Brook! Introducing out of the red corner, he weighed in at 146.4 pounds, wearing black trunks with gold trim. He brings a perfect record, 36 wins, no defeats, 27 victories coming by way of knockout. The former lightweight world champion, the former undisputed junior welterweight world champion, the reigning, defending WBO welterweight world champion, the pound for pound king from Omaha, Nebraska, Terrence Bud Crawford!
Okay, here we go. Okay, gentlemen, you both received your instructions in your dressing room. Okay, right here is good. Right here is good. I want a good, clean fight. Obey my commands at all times. Above all, protect yourselves at all times. Let's go.
Terrence Crawford again fighting not just an opponent, but the critics. The business of boxing, as he would simply tell you, the constant haters, those who try to debase his credentials, questioning who has he really fought, instead of looking at how he fights, what it looks like when he fights. The guy who's opposite him right now, Kell Brook, is a believer in how it should be done. Take the toughest fight. By doing that, he became a world champ once, and he had titanium fused to his orbital bones twice. Now he's refreshed. Can he do what no other fighter has, what 36 have failed at? We find out now. Round number one, and Dre, I offer you this. Among all the analysis of what could happen in this fight that gives Kell Brook hope is that Bud Crawford at times has been a slow starter. In fact, Dre, the fight we did against Egas Kaviaskis, Egas outlanded Crawford total punches over the course of the first three rounds. What should be Brook's approach early on?
Well, he can't get reckless, but he needs to start fast, start picking up that jab. I think Brook is realizing right now that Terrence Crawford is a lot longer than he realized, and the space between, you know, where he is now and actually hitting Crawford is a lot further than he realized. But yes, coming off 11-month layoff, being, you know, a slow starter historically, the first few rounds, Brook wants to win those. But it looks like Brook is playing Crawford's game now. He's watching, he's studying, and I don't think he can outthink Crawford. He's got to start to let that those hands go as he comes behind that left hand.
See, Brook thing is timing. That's his thing. He wants to time Crawford on the way in. You know, Brook also has a great jab, a sharp jab, a strong jab. And you can see Terrence Crawford trying to figure out how he can land his jab without getting hit. Another thing, Crawford typically comes out in a southpaw stance. but he came out in the right-handed stance, probably to confuse Kell Brook.
He has power in either hand, Crawford. He has finished guys, whether it is orthodox or southpaw, but in recent years, we have seen plenty of Crawford, mostly in the southpaw stance, and wildly effective in doing so. Here he comes out as a righty. And there is that jab from Kell Brook as he goes to the body against the champ.
Brook jabbing extremely well right now, not just to the head, but as you just saw, also to the body.
There he throws the right hand behind it.
Brook has a brilliant 1-2. It's automatic. It's his favorite combination, but his jab right now is landing.
He just scored with it accurately upstairs against Crawford.
And that's what it's about. It's about breaking the timing and the rhythm of Terrence Crawford. And you have to do that with your jab. Set it up. The power hand, which is the right hand for Brook.
Crawford looking to close that gap as he goes southpaw for a moment, doubles up the right-hand jab, and then comes with a left. Good exchange here as he switches back to righty. Fascinating first round. Going to take a short break. Back ringside here for round number two of our welterweight championship fight. Tim Bradley, in that first round, Kell Brook threw 17 jabs, effectively landed 6 of them.
Look, timing is what Kell Brook is special at. You know, he has a 69-inch reach. You have to understand that. He has the shorter arms in this matchup, but he knows when to throw his jab and at the right time, at the right distance, and at the right speed.
Funny to say that he doesn't have the reach. I mean, just look at the size advantage. Look at the size across the shoulders, across the back. Look at the muscles popping in the upper body of Kell Brook and the base he has as well, that foundation with the legs.
And see, what I noticed is that Kell Brook is taking a page out of Angus Kamayaskis. He's being patient. He's waiting. He's looking to counter Crawford. He's trying to get Crawford to commit so he can make him pay.
Jab is giving Crawford a lot of problems right now. You see him thinking, and Brook is doing the right thing. He's jabbing. That's the most important thing he can do right now because it sort of keeps him out of danger. It helps him to kind of create his range and where he wants to let his shots go, and it's also got Crawford thinking. The fight's going to get interesting if Crawford is able to make adjustments. I've seen Brook have a great plan A. He's got a great boxing ability, but when fights get deep and there's time to make adjustments, like in the Spence fight, I don't see him make that adjustment. We've seen Crawford do it in the past. He's going to have to do it right now because plan A, Brook has the advantage.
Spence fight happened in May of 2017. That was the last time Brook fought at this 147-pound limit. He was fighting brilliantly, and then Spence got to him with the power and scored an 11th-round TKO with a broken left orbital bone suffered.
You also want to see how Brook takes the shots of Crawford as he starts to land clean, flush shots.
Right now, it's a battle of patience. Neither fighter can afford to make a mistake, and as you see, Brook stepped in just a tad bit, and Terrence had combinations waiting on him.
Just fired off a right uppercut, did Kell Brook.
Brook has every punch in his arsenal. He has a strong left hook. He also has a straight right hand and a beautiful uppercut. And as you can see, his jab is giving Terrence Crawford problems. And Terrence goes southpaw.
Crawford switches for one of two reasons. Either he sees something or what he was doing in the right-handed stance wasn't working.
What do you suspect here, Dre?
I think the latter is true. The right-handed stance wasn't working, and he wants to see if he can get something going from the left hand.
Stop.
And a two in Vegas. You here in Vegas, round number three of the championship fight. According to CompuBox, Bud Crawford opponents land just 21% of their total punches. That is number one in the world among welterweights. So far tonight, Kell Brook is landing 36% of his punches against Terrence Crawford.
So don't think that Kell Brook is worried about Terrence Crawford going southpaw. He's not worried about that at all because he's used to that. He comes from the Ingles gym. He's used to seeing switch hitters in his gym, guys that switch from orthodox to southpaw. It's nothing to him.
You mentioned the Ingle gym. That is the veteran British trainer Dominic Ingle, who has trained Kell Brook since the start of his career. But Ingle opted out of this world title fight due to COVID concerns, because Kell Brook trains in the Canary Islands for training camp. Ingle did not want to travel and then have to quarantine nor come to the United States. So instead, Carlos Formento is the trainer in the corner of Kell Brook. First time they've ever worked together.
I'll tell you one thing that the southpaw stance has done. It's taking the jab away from Kell Brook. You see, he's not landing his jab consistently anymore.
Well, when Crawford turns southpaw, he's not even throwing.
That's what happens. That's what turning southpaw does. But it does allow you to land a right hand, like Brook just landed on Crawford right now.
A right hand,
hands free, hands free,
can be the best weapon against a southpaw. And of course, when he is in that lefty stance, you will see that right hand of Bud Crawford, as it is right now, hanging right over the front of Kell Brook.
Listen, Crawford has the reach advantage, but he's going to have to close the distance on Kell Brook. He told us in the build-up to this fight that Brook can't fight mid-range and in close. Right now, Brook is winning the battle from the outside. Crawford's got to slowly start to close that space.
There's that right lead again from Kell Brook. Minutes ago here in round three. Pretty good start for the challenger, the former IBF welterweight champion. A guy who says he's rejuvenated. Three fights since he lost the welterweight championship to Errol Spence.
That's how Errol Spence had success against Brook. He closed the distance and started to bully Kell Brook. He started to fight him in close. Brook fought back valiantly, but he really didn't have any answers for that.
See Crawford having his moments there.
I see some swelling already. Some swelling already on the right eye of Terrence Crawford in the right hand, right down the middle, that just lands for Kell Brook.
And there's a right hand from Crawford.
Way to answer that right hand.
Ha! End of three, Bernardo.
Alongside Shakur Stevenson, Miguel Burchell test positive for COVID-19. You step right in for December 12th. What do you expect from the fight against Toka Conclery?
I feel like it's going to be a massacre. I feel like good experience over me, and he's been around the game for a long time, but I just feel like I'm a way better fighter. My skill's going to take me to the next level in that fight.
You wanted to just keep the same opponent in Oscar Valdez for December 12th. How far did that conversation go?
I mean, Oscar's scared. Like, at the end of the day, I'm not going to keep begging Oscar for a fight. Now it's up to if he beat Burchell, and if he beat Burchell, me and him will end up fighting. But if not, it's going to be me and Burchell in the long run. He's ducking me, so that's just what it is.
Now, this is a perfect Shakur Stevenson-type fight. You were in Joshua Greer's corner, so what would your advice be to your boy Terrence Crawford here coming out for the fourth round?
I mean, he's starting to pick up the pace, and now it's time to pick up the pace. Kell don't like it when somebody go at him and beat him up.
Thank you very much, champ. Look forward to seeing you December. Joe.
One of the youngest rising stars in the sport, Shakur Stevenson, saying he expects his good friend Terrence Bud Crawford to pick up the pace here. CompuBox has Kell Brook 24 of 99 punches, Crawford 25 of 93. Shakur Stevenson will fight December 12th in this ring against Toka Conclery. Shakur, the recent featherweight champion, now contending at 130 pounds, looking for a showdown for a belt here. Round number four.
Crawford has to continue to get his lead foot outside the lead foot of Brook to have success with his offense. That will put him in a safe position to let his combinations go. Beautiful right hand.
And the champ gets to him.
Get over here.
Just like that.
Get over here.
Terrence Bud Crawford hits the gas.
7. 8. Come to me. You all right?
Yeah.
Give you a chance.
One of the best closers in the game. 27 knockouts in his career. Do we have 28 right here?
This fight is awesome.
Thundering in. Look at Crawford. Vicious attack to close it.
No.
And he stares him down.
Okay. No.
With his family here, his wife Isha, Miss Deborah, his mom, he does it again. Slow start. devastating power punches in that fourth round. And as good of a start as Kell Brook had, Crawford demolishes him.
That's why this is called a 12-round fight. Slow start, but great finish. Great finish. You got to account for that 12-month layoff for Terrence Bud Crawford.
Kell Brook just said to his corner, what happened? Bud Crawford just happened.
Fellas, I said I wanted to see what Kell Brook does when he tastes the power of Terrence Crawford. Well, we just got our answer.
There it is.
They have come from Omaha. They took COVID tests today to enter the bubble. His family is here to witness the next chapter, the 37th win, the 28th knockout, the newly minted number one pound-for-pound fighter in the world. Came out to prove his status. What do we say that he told us yesterday? That this is the hurt business, that you don't play boxing, and he would show everybody. See Bo Mack, Brian McIntyre, his longtime manager and trainer. It is a dynamic team that they have built in Omaha, Nebraska. There were many doubters early on saying, who is this young guy and who are these trainers? Well, they're top of the business right now. That's who they are. All right, guys, Timmy, take us through how he closed the show.
Listen
here in round
this
four.
This was like a jab. Like a right hook, right on the money, right on the button. And you see the legs right there of Brook as he wobbled back to that corner. Nice finish up right here, combination from Terrence Bud Crawford. You know, sometimes your opponent can do the work for you. As you can see, Kell Brook was moving forward. He shot a jab out there. Crawford timed it over the top with a nice, short, I would say jab, hook. Jam,
that's
hook type.
That's the first knockdown. Remember, the ropes held him up.
Boom. And you know, that shot wasn't even on the chin. That shot was right on the eye, and it had that type of effect on Kell Brook. That shows you what type of devastating punching power Terrence Bud Crawford possesses.
And then how he finishes, and Dre, he gets that look in his eyes.
At this point, the fight was as good as done because Terrence Crawford is one of the best finishers in the game. You can't be hurt like that against Crawford, especially knowing that he had a slow start. He wants to come in here and prove a point and remind everybody why he's atop that list, and that's how you do it. Once again, to your point, Tim, it's not a 3 or 4 round fight. It's a 12-round fight or less. And I wanted to see the reaction from Kell Brook once Terrence Crawford landed a clean shot and we got our answer. And Terrence finished the fight like he typically does when he gets a fighter hurt. In brutal fashion, Tony Weeks got in there just in time because things were about to get ugly.
And Jay, did you see the face, the feet placement for Terrence Bud Crawford? When he got his foot outside with that, they were just lead foot. Devastating combinations to finish the action.
Miss Deborah's mom has a mask that reads pound for pound on it. The chopping right hands on the final sequence, and then the two piston-like driving left hand.
Take nothing away from Kell Brook. He was here. He came to win. You can tell. You can see. He was in this fight. I don't know how you had it, but it was about two rounds, I thought, to one.
Let's make it official. Here's Mark Chinook.
Ladies and gentlemen, here inside MGM Grand, referee Tony Weeks calls a halt to this bout at 1 minute, 14 seconds of round number four, declaring your winner by technical knockout, and still WBO welterweight champion of the world, Terrence Bud Crawford!
Terrence Crawford, folks, is 37-0 with 28 knockouts. He's the number one pound-for-pound fighter in the world for a reason. One more time, and then we will hear from him. How he finishes. Chopping right, driving left, driving left. See ya, Mr. Brook. Head back to Sheffield, England. Take your $2 million. And it was this from the southpaw stance of Terrence Bud Crawford, the short right hand, that little hook that started the end of things in devastating fashion. Terrence Crawford, after a calculated start, after Kell Brook had success with the jab, makes the adjustment, goes southpaw, puts on the power show, and now he's with Bernardo.
All right, Terrence Crawford still discussing the victory with promoter Bob Arum. Terrence, it was close until it wasn't. What did you see that you were able to take advantage of?
Well, I was just trying to gauge the distance. You know, he had good distance, you know, and I was trying to find my rhythm in between, you know, getting my distance together. And, you know, that's why it was so competitive at first. I couldn't get my shots off.
What adjustments were you able to make to finally get to, Kell Brook?
Well, you know, just step forward a little more, throw a little more punches, but not too much. And I caught up with him a couple of times.
I know that you always talk about having to excel the expectations for you. Well, you did tonight because it took Errol Spence 11 rounds to beat him, and you did it in four. Does that mean anything to you?
Not at all. You know, it was different fights, you know, different, years and whatnot. But Kell's a tremendous talent. I can't take nothing away from him. He came and he tried to take my title. He was in shape. He made the weight. So there was no excuses to be put on the table. He just came off of three wins, not coming off of a loss. So he had his confidence up, and he lost to the better man tonight.
You've been clear. The names you want are Manny Pacquiao, Errol Spence. How do you make that happen?
Let me tell you something. And I mean this. Spence and Garcia are fighting December 5. If they really want to make a big pay-per-view, I'll put Terrence Crawford in with both of them, one at a time, and he beat both of them the same night. He is far and away the best welterweight in the world. He goes back to the great welterweights like Ray Leonard and Tommy Hearns. He would have been competitive with them. The welterweights around now are not competitive with Terrence Crawford.
And Bob, you know that what made that era great is that everybody fought everybody. And you were able to make the fights with the heavyweights, Deontay Wilder and Tyson Fury, twice. Will we see Bud in the ring with Errol Spence in the near future?
Errol Spence will try to avoid Terrence Crawford as long as he can because he knows he can't beat Terrence Crawford. You saw the performance tonight. I mean, he'll take out Errol Spence in about the same number of rounds like he took out Kell Brook.
Now, we all want to see that fight. I know you want that fight. There was a lot written this week. Where are you, Terrence, in terms of your future?
I'm looking to secure a Pacquiao fight. You know, we was close to securing a Pacquiao fight prior to this fight. But being that the COVID, you know, was getting out of hand, the fans couldn't attend the fight, so we had to put a halt to it, and that's when we decided to go with Kell Brook. He was the next available known welterweight that was available to fight. So now we're going to go back to the drawing board and try to revisit that fight with Manny Pacquiao.
We all know that with Pacquiao, it's money. Bob, is it all there for this fight to finally happen in 2021?
Money,
I know Terrence has wanted it, you wanted it.
The money was there. It had been committed. It was a fight that was going to take place in a country in the Mideast. And then the Minister of Health in that country said, you can't do it because I can't guarantee that we'll allow spectators, and it would have been this week. So he was right. Now they've called us, and they said, if Terrence is successful, we want to resume the talks and see if we can do it in the spring, either before or after Ramadan.
Looks like we're going to the Middle East.
Let's go.
Thank you very much, Terrence. Thank you very much, Bob. Joe, back to you.